Distinguished colleagues on the stage and in the audience, all those who have come from far and wide to this conference, I wish to first thank the organizers of this event for inviting me to speak here today. Quick calculation, we were still raising the days when we had to do all this quite fast mentally, which tells me that I have 3 minutes. Okay, or something of that sort. Anyway, I don't want to say too many things. I just want to point out a few things. I believe a large part of this audience are teachers like me. So we are grappling with this issue of what has been mentioned, the fast-changing environment. How do we educate our children, our students who are coming out to be prepared for this future? The first thing is, of course, not to inculcate fear, to remove fear. And for this, I believe that one of the things we have to do very rapidly is to move some distance at least away from this heavy syllabus-loaded, curriculum-loaded, assembly line kind of approach to education where they have to learn this and they have to learn that and they have to learn everything and pack their schedule. There were some hidden advantages to that. It inculcated discipline, it inculcates ability to do hard work, to be regular and so on. All of those we must continue to inculcate. But we need to actually free up the belt around the waist and allow the people to explore. We have to create the environment by which they will learn quite a lot, not only through the classroom, but also through experiential learning. I think the incubation centers are very important. Internships are very important. We have to enable our students to start interning. I would say all of this has to go back and start somewhere in the 11th and 12th itself, but at least at the colleges. The second thing is these the speed varies in different domains. As was pointed out, it's not clear what will happen when. What is clear is that changes will occur. And the speed at which two things are happening, one is automation and the other is the use of what is broadly called artificial intelligence. So whatever, what can be automated keeps changing as technology improves. People are attempting driverless cars in certain contexts. But in our context, you never know, flipping dosas can become automated suddenly. It all depends on when the combination of camera, robotic hand, sensors, and so on comes to the end. They have somebody smart who can figure all this out, does the right thing, gets it at a cost point where it's less expensive than hiring a master and with much more reliability because this one will not take leave and so on and so forth. So at that point, the change will occur. This will happen in agriculture. This will happen in many, many things. This is unavoidable. Of course, there'll be jobs created by those who make these things, by the innovators, the startups, and so on, but a lot of jobs will be lost. So where will these jobs go and what will happen? This is where the artificial intelligence part comes in. As the term implies, what AI is trying to do is use computing to try to come up with the kind of decisions, the kind of analysis, the kind of understanding that an experienced human being with sufficient amount of data inputs is able to do. A way I like to think about this, and I'd like to share it with you, is to think of these large communities or joint families even, where the patriarch or matriarch is able to see everything, know what's going on with every individual, and has all the inputs, sensory inputs, he sees what's happening to the person, understands the capabilities and weaknesses of each individual, and then is able to decide or help decide what has to be done to make each person productive, happy, individual, and so on. So it's this kind of a thing. What that individual is able to do in their brain is what people are attempting to do. It's not easy. So wherever again, certain amount of a problem is simple enough, or there's been understood well enough to be able to partly model and partly learn from analyzing data to be cracked, and where you find that the solutions that you are getting are quite good, then you immediately have a productivity increase and repetitive part of the job will disappear. So if you're giving bank loans in a bank, there's a certain repetitive part of the job, looking at the data, understanding, figuring out the credit worthiness of the person and so on. a lot of that will disappear. But suddenly, finally, if you have the experience, that sixth sense, the common sense, look to interview the person, figure out whether after all that, this is the right person to give a loan to or not, this is the right project or not, that part alone will probably survive. But even that, the boundary will keep shifting. So the people who develop these tools will require to understand how to build these systems. So you'll need to learn about machine learning, artificial intelligence, the tools of these. Today it will be Python, tomorrow it will be Cobra. We'll have to keep adapting. But the point really is, we have to introduce, as these new techniques and skills and knowledge emerges, we have to introduce them to students in colleges. We have to learn ourselves as teachers. For this, in the IIT system, you know, as you all know, or you might know, we have developed this very extensive program called NPTEL, by which we now connect every semester with so many colleges. Today, the engineering colleges alone is 1,200 now. We have local chapters. We offer these massive online courses. This semester, almost a million students in the country have taken these courses. About 1/10 of them are writing the exams at the end and getting certified. So many teachers are working with our faculty in offering this course at the colleges. We are introducing many courses in this program, not only in the engineering, the standard engineering courses, but also courses for AI, machine learning, and so on. So we are running faculty development programs on a smaller scale, of course, face-to-face with faculty. So this, all of that has to go on in parallel. But I think the point is that since the pace of change is rapid, it's important to let our students learn in parallel on their own and learn experientially. And as when they go to work, they'll find that these kinds of boundaries will keep shifting. Many things will get automated, both in the actual doing part of it with robots as well as in the thinking part of it through computing, through the use of AI tools. But they will be able to handle it, and there'll always be a role finally for the real intelligence, because there are so many things that cannot be captured through these models and through these AI tools. And the jobs will shift towards that part. To enable these people to perform that part where the human mind is really required, we have to free them up. It's not enough for students just to learn the curriculum and be narrow. They have to be able to grapple with uncertainty, with changing environment of whatever it is they are addressing. So this is the only message I want to share with you. The rest we can take with questions. Thank you.